Well, budget negotiations back on track at the State House. The conferees, as they are called, have come to terms on some major sticking points that include pension reform and retiree benefit cost savings. David Collins keeping a close eye on the discussions. He joins us now live from Annapolis with the very latest. David?
Marianne, it's let's make a deal time in Annapolis, and budget negotiators seem to be in a compromising mood.
And you're both in the same general vicinity of about $120 million.
Progress. House and Senate budget negotiators have come to terms on pension reform and retiree benefits. The compromise contains elements from both chambers and the governor's plan, saving the state $7 billion in retiree costs by the year 2020. Pension reform expedites the timetable to address unfunded liabilities. It means the system will be 80% solvent by 2023.
We can offer incredible benefits, but if we can't pay for them, we haven't done a service to our employees or retirees.
All employees will have to pay 7% of their salaries to the pension system. That's up from 5%. Cost of living increases are guaranteed at 1% a year as long as inflation rises by 1%. In years where the pension fund meets or exceeds a return of 7.5%, employees would get a 2% cost of living adjustment. The calculation to determine pensions has been lowered. It's called the multiplier, the rate times years of service. It dips from 1.8 to 1.5% for new employees and will expire in 10 years. Budget conferees also found a compromise in the retirement age. The rule of 90 will apply to those who want to retire before 65. Under this formula, state workers' years of service plus their age would have to equal 90. The Senate budget bill put the number at 92.
Because we think it's important to approve a plan that's manageable for people who are living with very limited resources.
Prescription drug costs will be capped at $1,500 for individuals and $2,000 for couples. The caps will not increase with inflation as sought by the Senate. They are $2 million apart on funding for stem cell research. The House agrees with the governor on $12.4 million figure. The Senate wants to trim it to $10.4 million. The Senate planned to study merging College Park with the University of Maryland Baltimore as a Senate budget item. The House still needs to act. The House also needs to act on a Senate proposal to raise the alcohol tax by 3% over the next 3 years. In a one-time-only deal, the Senate will use part of the revenues to restore cuts in education funding to Baltimore City and Prince George's County.
If they were to send it to me, I'd certainly be likely to sign it.
And just a few minutes ago, they agreed on funding stem cell research at $12.4 million. Reporting live from Annapolis, David Collins, WBAL-TV 11 News.